New production technologies and sustainability. The textile industry, especially dyeing and finishing, is blamed for being an inefficient energy consumer as well as a big polluter. The industries of the sector are under pressure to change to sustainable processes. New technologies promise a better environmental performance for the textile and clothing industry, while they also enhance the efficiency of operations. Supercritical carbon hydroxide dyeing. A supercritical fluid, for example carbon dioxide, is a substance at high pressure and temperature which performs both like a liquid and a gas. Supercritical carbon dioxide is a solvent with specific advantages and can replace water in dyeing processes. Due to practical reasons, carbon dioxide is the most commonly used supercritical fluid. The advantages of supercritical fluid dyeing over traditional wet dyeing methods are: it's a simpler method. There is no wastewater, just a solvent that vaporizes. No cleaning of the textile is needed. Supercritical fluid is removed very easily from the fabric. High dyeing efficiency. And dye remains can be reused. Operation cycle is shortened. On the other hand, equipment required for the process is quite expensive, and the technology is not mature yet for natural fibers. Plasma technology treatment. Plasma is a gas that is partially ionized, which means that some of its atoms are separated in free electrons and positive charged nucleus. It is volatile and chemically reactive and can be used for surface treatment of textiles. The plasma equipment is relatively cheap, energy consumption is lower than in the waste process, and there are no wastewater produced. Microwave-assisted processes. In this technology, microwaves are used as heating medium, hence reducing the energy consumption of processes like desizing, scouring, dyeing, bleaching, drying. Ultrasound colorization. Ultrasound enzyme-assisted coloration enhances the coloration process of fibers with lower processing times, better product quality and less enzymes consumption. Ecological fibers, hemp, rami, jute, flax, alternatives to cotton that are cultivated in sustainable ways are gradually getting consumer acceptance. Marketable products with trade names Monocell from bamboo, Lyocell from wood pulp, C-cell from algae, Edelweiss, Cupro, acetate and 3-acetate new fibers made from byproducts and waste of the food industry. Cue meals are fibers from rejected milk. Escafe fibers are recycled fibers. Although the use of recycled fibers is much better for the environment than that of the virgin ones, the quality of the material is reduced in every recycling process. Substitution of virgin fibers with recycled ones is not yet mature. And this is due not only to quality issues, but also to the fact that it does not make business sense. Conventional and petroleum-based fibers are very cheap, and there is a need to impose duties on them or subsidize the recycled fibers for substitution to take place. Alternative chemicals. Substitution of harmful chemicals with safer ones is a good way to reduce the environmental impact of business, but on the other hand, it is a hard and complicated task. Several technological advancements exist, and many more are under development. For instance, modified starch has been developed as an environmentally friendly seizing agent that will substitute, partially or completely, polyvinyl alcohol. A chemical substitution project should follow the following procedure and steps. Identify chemicals that need to be substituted and the importance of substitution. These should be based on legal requirements or business improvement incentives. Define the role it has in the production process or the properties that the chemical gives to the product. Define the criteria, technical, functional, business, for the alternatives. Search for available alternative solutions from chemical producers, bibliography, or scientific research. Identify chemicals that need to be substituted. Evaluate alternatives according to the criteria you set in step 3. Test in realistic production conditions, short time or in a pilot scale. Evaluate the results of the test. Proceed to substitution if evaluation gives satisfactory results. Otherwise, perform again the procedure starting at the appropriate step depending on the parameters that led to failure of the test. Conclusion. The textile industry is under pressure to change to more sustainable processes. New technologies in materials and production will assist this change while improving the efficiency of operations. Main axes for change to sustainability are alternatives to wet processes, process water and wastewater rejection, new alternative fibers, alternative materials for finishing and dyeing,